everyone, myself Roshan Kukreja, and I am here to speak a few words on the mesmerizing discoveries of the recent times. Before I start my topic, I would like to ask, are we all connected to the various social networking sites to gather information? Yes, of course, here we are. But here are some of the discoveries to boost up your knowledge. So, before starting my topic, I want a huge cheer up for all of you to get the new information about the discoveries. Thank you everyone. So I begin. My first topic is the origin of the gravitational waves. We all know what is gravity, but have you ever thought where did it come from? So the Nobel winning research we could see after the discovery of the Bang Bang. The disturbance detected by the laser interferometer gravitational waves observatory, that is the LIGO machineries, for the fourth time in August, was supposed to be caused by the colliding black holes weighing the dozen times the mass of the sun. Earlier, due to the less development of the LIGO machineries and observatories, some questions like what caused that, what was the direction of that wave, were remain unanswered. But now, due to the recent development in the machineries and observatories, we could detect the presence as well as the direction and the location of the waves. This research in our history is as same as the Galileo looking for the telescope in the sky for the first time. The recent researches say that the black holes that resulted into the development of the gravitational waves collided 1.3 billion years ago, and as the time went up, frequencies of these waves increases. Further, researches are made to find answers to the various questions related to the topic. Further, I would like to talk about the wonderful discovery of time crystals, the fourth state of matter. We all know that crystals of a carbon lattice of a diamond have atomic structure that repeats itself in space. But the time crystals are such crystals that repeat itself in space as well as in time. The time crystals, also known as space-time crystals, have structures that repeat in time and space and that repeats periodically in time as well as in space. The difference between the time crystals and the normal crystals is that the normal three-dimensional crystals repeat only in space but remain unchanged with the time. Time crystals repeat in space as well as in time, leading to creation of different structures from every moment to moment. Isn't it amazing? Proceeding further, I would like to speak a few words on the mystery of the second moon of the Earth. We all know we are on a planet having a single moon. But developments say that we are no longer a single moon planet. A small asteroid named 2016 HO3 has been trapped in the Earth's orbit. So it is said that we are no longer a single moon planet. Further, it is also said that although it has been in an irregular orbit or irregular fashion, but a scientist say in the coming time it would be in a regular orbit as our moon does. So also perhaps the calculation also say that once it would be in its proper orbit, it would be there for the centuries to come. So we can make plans to be up on a planet having the two moons. Proceeding further is the Proxima B, an exoplanet having except Earth to show the signs of habitability. Proxima Centauri, the nearest star to our Sun, is found to have a planetary system consisting of at least one planet having mass 1/10 of our Sun. The exoplanet Proxima B is found to be detected around the Proxima Centauri and its mass is approximately as of the Earth. Proxima B is a planet belonging to the planetary system of the Proxima Centauri and is the only planet except the Earth in our universe to allow liquid water on its surface. Perhaps it is also called as an ocean planet having a water surface covering its entire surface. So next I would like to speak about the mystery of the eighth continent under the waters. We all know that we have seven continents on our surface of the Earth. But the eighth continent, but the landmass having the characteristics of a continent is found to be on the surface of the Earth. This was named as New Zealandia. New Zealandia is the landmass having 90% of its having 90% of its landmass submerged under the Pacific Ocean. This landmass was found to be between the two islands of New Zealand and New Caledonia. Its only point above the surface of the water is between that the two islands of New Zealand and New Caledonia, and is estimated to be the highest point of the continent. Further, it has also some of the key characteristics of as far as physiographic aspects are concerned. Now, attempts are also made to find new things about the continent. So, I shared these discoveries to give you awareness about the various planets and continents. So, thank you.